How's it going, guys? We're out here wet sanding. This area I'm wet sanding. This area I haven't touched. I'm going to take a minute out to talk about, I guess, basically what I've done and what I'm using here. This clear. Okay? Now, as you guys know, I did my homework before I bought the products I bought. That's why I had multiple brands. I risked using multiple brands, even though they said they were all compatible. We know how that can go. But I would never use a different brand, like hardener, with an item. I just don't go that way, even though I'm sure it'll work. Okay? Now, I did a lot of research on the clear, and if you guys remember, that was the last thing I had to buy. And as you guys know, I haven't painted in a long time. Okay, so I consider myself a hobbyist. I don't consider myself a professional. Okay. Things have definitely changed. Okay, I did a lot of research, and if you guys remember, I narrowed it down to three different clears. I had narrowed it down to the PPG. I narrowed it down to the SPI. And I narrowed it down to the wet. Not necessarily in that order. It's just the order I figured I would say it. Okay. I figured the Deltron, the PPG, would be a safe bet. You know, I used it a long time ago. You know, that would be a safe bet, even though you go on the forums and it's some people like it, some people don't like it. It's just the way it is. You know, it's like that in everything in the world, that I could tell you. Okay. Then I narrowed it down to SPI and the Autobahn wet. And I started doing research. I couldn't really find any videos online of the SPI, but there's a lot of talk of it on the forums, and a lot of people definitely swear by it. But like I said before, they offer no information whatsoever on using a siphon feed gun, and they actually say in their on their homepage, when they talk about it, they actually say that there's no place for a siphon gun in a body shop. So I was like, okay, we're done. You know, we're going old school here. That's what I used to spray way back when. I don't care if I'm going to waste a little bit of material. Okay? See, I'll give you something to look at. Okay? So that narrowed it down to the wet and the PPG Deltron. And I started cruising the internet doing my homework on the wet. And it's funny, I couldn't find one complaint. Like I said, I couldn't find one complaint on the SPI either, but I had to eliminate it because if there's a problem, or if I needed advice, where would I go? And I don't care how long you've been doing it. If you switch brands or you switch an item, there's going to be questions. It's just the way it is. That's the way of the world, you know. Stuff changes so quickly, you can't keep up on it. So, but if you're in the field, I'm sure you can go with the changes gradually like I do in my field, okay? I am a professional, but not a professional at bodywork. So that left me with the wet. And after doing my homework and seeing that there's nobody complaining about it, plus this was the selling factor of it, was the person that's actually pushing it, Ten, is actually making videos, and they're not like pieced together, edited videos. It is what it is. You know, someone's holding the camera, he's holding the camera, everybody's holding the camera, and he's painting. And he goes over his candy, he goes over the clears, he goes over pressures, he goes over gun settings, he goes over everything if you follow the videos. Okay, plus he shows you the real world stuff. He's painting in an open area, you know what I mean? So he explains he's going to get some dust or whatever it is, and, you know, but he shows you spraying it, and as he's done lifting the gun away, they're there with the camera, and there's no peel on it. Now, I know he's been spraying it a while, and I know he's helped alter the formula. If I understand correctly, I could be wrong. So he has a lot more experience than I'm ever going to have. But I found that just the information I was able to get from him, it wasn't like when I called him, it was like, okay, let me just get this guy off the phone, I got stuff to do. It's no. I'm going to keep explaining it to you till you understand it type of information. That's the information I need. You guys know I'm honest. You guys know I say it as it is. I do have a filter, but I say it as it is. I don't like to sugarcoat anything. Just tell me what it is so I can make an educated decision. And I love information, so I can process it in my head and then make decisions. You know, I lay it all out and move on from there. And I don't even know how many conversations we've had to date, including the one we had today. Because right before I was ready to spray it, I called him just to talk about some things, talk about that So Bright silver that I received accidentally, and all the stuff. And then he walked me through it multiple times. And he told me to send him pictures or whatever when I was done, which I did. And he could have just let it go at that. But he went out of his way to call me to make sure everything was okay. And I actually missed the call the first time, and we spoke again today. So, I'm not going to try and be a salesman, but like I said to you guys before, this was rough as sandpaper. This was rough as 60 grit. Okay, all this flake isn't laying flat. Okay, so if I was able to do this, okay, can you imagine what you guys could do? And most of you guys are professionals. Can you imagine what you guys could do with this stuff? I don't know what the chemical makeup is, but the best way I could describe what this looks like, this almost looks like old school, like enamel, where it's, I don't want to describe it wrong, but it's almost like the coat was just dipped in plastic. And now that this is sanded down, you can't tell. But when I was panning across this the other day, I was reading everything off that crystal clear. This is hard to tell because you got the ribs in it and there's all water running down from me, wet sanding and stuff like that. But like I said, this is glass. The reason I'm wet sanding is I did get some dirt in the center. I picked it up on my hose. I used that cloth hose. That was my mistake. So now I'm getting it out. I could have just gave it a basic wet sanding. I think it was thick enough, and then wheel it. But this way, he always does a re-clear, so now I'm blocking this down. I'm going to put another three coats on this, and then when we go to wheel it, we should be money. You know what I mean? So, like I said, guys, I don't consider myself a professional. So, you could see it. Do I even have to say it? The actual glitter takes away from the reflection of what you're looking at over there. But this stuff's going to pop outside in here. He has the stuck in a cup. Me and Junior waited for this to skin over, and I took it out of the cup. I didn't want mine stuck in a cup. Look what you're looking through. First of all, where's the solvent pump? Look how thick that is. I'm going to say that's 2 inches? Inch and 3/4? Look, you're looking through. You're reading what's on my wall. Is it a girl? Can't get past the girl. There you go. Oops, sorry. I got the blurry spot right on the girl. There you go. So when they talk about the wet, wet look, from what I understand, the word wet, wet, or the word wet comes from clarity. And I would say that this thing's got some clarity to it. So, I promised him a video when I was done, but I felt a little obligated to make a video now as I'm working on it. So in case he sees something I'm doing wrong, he can explain it to me. So, well, that's it, guys. Hope everybody has a good night. And I'm going to sand because I only have a little bit of time before we do the re-clear. And I'm not rushing nothing. So, with that, take care, everybody. I'll give you one last shot of the product. That's the So Bright Silver. That's what you use on the candy. There's the Wet Wet. He also sells the Wet Wet Plus. This is a high solid clear. The Wet Wet Plus is a high solid clear with a little bit more content to it. There's the activator. It's obviously allcandy.com, and he sells candy, so over the winter, like I said, he gave this to me, which is pretty nice. Over the winter, we're going to do a candy job on something. I'm just not sure what yet, but we'll find something to do a candy job on. So, well, that's it, guys.